Good morning, AGC. It's good to be back with you again for our chapel time. Glad to have you all with us. So I'm going to invite you, we're going to sing some songs like we normally do. So can you all stand up for me? We're going to sing Jesus Loves Me. You all know that song. And we're going to do some of the actions with it, right? So this is Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. You ready? Here we go. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. Let's do that again. Here we go. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. Great job, everyone. Great job. That's such a great song, isn't it? It's a reminder that we need to have with us each and every day to know that God loves us, no matter what. All right, we're going to do, He's Got the Whole World. Ready? So we got to have our world ready. Here we go. He's got the whole world in His hands. 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 Little bitty baby. He's got the little bitty baby in His hands. He's got the little bitty baby in His hands. He's got the little bitty baby in His hands. He's got the whole world in His hands. Everybody here. He's got everybody here in His hands. He's got everybody here in His hands. He's got everybody here in His hands. He's got the whole world in His hands. About all our teachers. He's got all our teachers in His hands. He's got all our teachers in His hands. He's got all our teachers in His hands. He's got the whole world in His hands. How about Pastor Terry? Here we go. He's got Pastor Terry in His hands. He's got Pastor Terry in His hands. He's got Pastor Terry in His hands. He's got the whole world in His hands. Whole world. He's got the whole world in His hands. 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 Great job, everyone. Great job. Fantastic. I wish I could hear your voices because I know you are such great singers. We're going to do Oh How I Love Jesus. We did this one not too long ago. It's somewhat a new song to us. But we're going to try it together. You ready? Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Because He first loved me. Again. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. because he first loved me. Awesome. Great job, everybody. Can you all sit down for a moment? I want to share something with you today. Everybody get seated. All right. Fantastic. There is a particular verse in the Bible that a lot of people have memorized, and I'm pretty sure that most of you have heard it. It's John 3:16, and sometimes it's called the Bible in the nutshell. Well, what does that mean? So it means that all of the stories of the Bible can somewhat be summed up in this one verse. And that verse is, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him may not perish, but have everlasting life." That's a wonderful verse, reminds us of God's love for us. And as I think about that verse, I started thinking about, how can we measure God's love for us? That's an interesting question. So I brought some things along today. How many of you have helped your parents or someone bake something? Oh, a lot of you. Great. I really like when someone bakes cookies. But when we bake cookies, or when we do any kind of baking, we have to measure things. That's how that works. So I brought some measuring spoons along so we can add various ingredients to the cookies. And sometimes I didn't have a measuring cup, but a measuring cup also is one of those things that we use to maybe put the amount of flour in. Maybe we have to measure if we put nuts in the cookie. Some of you don't like nuts, that's okay. But we have to measure the ingredients in order to make delicious cookies. So I wonder, do you think we could measure God's love with a measuring spoon or a measuring cup? That's an interesting question. There's a verse in the Bible that tells us that God's love for us is like a cup overflowing. Oh, wow. So if the cup's overflowing, then I don't think we can measure it with a measuring cup, can we? Because it's more than that. So what else? What other things do we use to measure things with? If we wanted to measure how tall you were, or if we wanted to measure how long it was to something, or how wide something was, what would we use? Yeah, a measuring tape, right? So we can measure out how long something is. If we were building something, we'd have to measure it and make a mark, and then we could cut the wood and start building our little project or whatever. So, what do you think? Could we measure God's love with measuring tape? This tape is 25 feet long. It goes on a long time. Do you think we can measure God's love with a measuring tape? Well, again, there's a verse in the Bible that says Jesus' love is deeper than the ocean. Wow. Higher than the heavens. So I guess we can't really measure God's love with a measuring tape either, can we? Oh, wow. How are we going to do this? I know. How is it that we measure how long it takes to do something? Yeah, that's right. We use a stopwatch. Now, I bring a stopwatch with me because my stopwatch is on my phone and I'm recording this video and I can't show it to you and still be on the video. But a stopwatch allows us to time the start and the end of something. How long something lasts in time, we can measure that with a stopwatch. So I wonder, can we measure God's love with a stopwatch? How long God loves us? Well, again, there's a Bible verse that tells us that God's love is from everlasting to everlasting. Wow. That means God loves us more than we can measure, more than we can measure with measuring spoons, more than we can measure with a measuring tape, and more than we can measure with a stopwatch. That is so cool. God's love is beyond anything that we can measure. You know, when God shared that verse with us, that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have everlasting life, he was talking about Jesus. Jesus is God's Son. And God loved all of us, all people, so much that he came to be one of us in Jesus. God became human, and we know the story of how Jesus taught us, showed us how we are to live our lives, and yet he died. He was killed on a cross, and he died for us, for our sins, for the things that we do wrong, that we might receive forgiveness from God. That's awesome. And Jesus didn't stop at dying on the cross. He actually was raised from the dead 3 days later. And Jesus is with God. And Jesus promised to be with all of us. Well, we can't see Jesus like the people of that day did, not in person, but we can see Jesus in other things. We can see Jesus in the trees, in the birds, in all of nature. We can see Jesus in one another. God told us that we were all created in God's image. So when we see one another, we can kind of see what God looks like. And God loves each and every one of us. One of the things that we do as disciples of Jesus, because God loved us, we love other people. Yeah. So how is it that you can love other people around you? How do you show your parents that you love them? Yeah, you can give them a hug, right? You can do the things that they ask you to do. That's a way of showing your love. Oh yeah, and you're right. We can simply say from our heart, I love you. And we can tell people that God loves them as well. God's love for us is such a great thing. It helps us in every day, when we're at school, when we're at home, when we're at play, to always know that God is with us and that God loves us is one of the most important things we can always remember. So I hope that perhaps if you're helping bake something and you see a measuring cup or measuring spoons, or maybe you're helping your parents with a project and you're measuring something with a measuring tape, or even if you're just thinking about time, that you would just remember that God's love for us goes beyond anything we can measure. God loves you guys, and I love you too. Thank you for listening to my story. We're going to close our time with a prayer. And so I'm going to say some words of a prayer and have you can repeat those words after me. I'll give you time to do that. So let's get ready to pray. Let's bow our heads, fold our hands, close our eyes, and pray with me. Gracious God, we love you. Thank you for loving us. Thank you for sending Jesus to be one of us. And thank you, God, for allowing Jesus to die and rise again, so that we might be forgiven and have that promise of life forever with you. Help us, Jesus, to show your love to all people, to everyone we meet. We thank you, Jesus, for your love. Amen. Thank you all so much for being with me today. I look forward to seeing you as you come to school. I hope you have a great day. Take care. Bye.